And a good day, everybody. I'm Jewel with the J7409 Tropical Update. So glad you joined me this morning to check out what's happening with the tropical weather. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Click subscribe, click the bell, and get all the latest in tropical weather updates. I would appreciate it so very much. Here we have the 5-day outlook from the National Hurricane Center. Before I go any further, though, I would like to explain something to some of you guys. It's like, maybe you already know this. If you do, excuse me, but if you don't, maybe we can learn something together. The other day, I put an equation up. Well, there's a lot of math that goes into forecasting hurricanes, and it's a lot of calculus. A lot of calculus. And the National Hurricane Center, as well as other places, this is how they do it. Okay, did you know there was 58 dynamic models that you go by? 58. And then there's 47 statistical, consensus, and trajectory models. Now you're going, well, how in the world do they figure all of that up? Well, each model, like a lot of you are used to the GFS or the Euro model for the most part, each of these have many different suites of models that go with them, okay? And what they do is they have a supercomputer. They put all the information from all of these different models in, and the computer computes what should happen with the information from these models. But right now, Humberto, up here, 90 mile per hour winds, minimum central pressure, 966 millibars. It's located 30.6 north, 74.3 west. It's moving east northeast at 8 miles per hour, and it should stay well away from the Canadian coastline and the eastern United States seaboard areas. It should be clear of all of this. Then we have this system, which should bring a lot of rain, which I've said all along, it's not probably going to have a lot of wind. You might get a little bit of wind, maybe 20, 30 mile per hour wind gusts sometimes, but for the most part, it's going to bring rain to Texas and a little rain to Louisiana, and then it should move on up, might even bring rain up in this area later on. But as of right now, it's looking like it's still just a low pressure over northwestern Gulf of Mexico. It's a little more concentrated during the past several hours. Now, the nearby observations are indicating that although pressures are falling in the area, there are no signs of a surface circulation at this time. There's no vorticity in it, folks. Now, a little bit of development is possible before the system moves inland along the northwestern Gulf Coast tomorrow night. Now, regardless of development, this system is expected to produce locally heavy rainfall and possible flash flooding along portions of the central and upper Texas coastal areas later this week. I think you guys in Texas, once it starts maybe coming up or tonight in Texas, you can get rain possibly in different areas as it moves through all the way through Friday. Now it's looking like 48 hours 30, 5 days 30. Now over here we got this system, and I'm not only going to talk about this system, but there is possibly another one coming, folks, that it would be bigger than this system. Now, right now, this, of course, is disturbance number one. It's a small area of low pressure. It's located more than 1,000 miles east of the Lesser Antilles, and it continues to produce disorganized showers and thunderstorms, and this system has changed little in organization since yesterday, but conditions are still expected to be conducive for the formation of a tropical depression during the next day or so while this system moves slowly northwestward to west-northwestward. In 2 days, 70%, 5 days, 90%. I do think this will become Imelada. Okay, I do think this will become Imelada. Now, when we go over to the tracking map for Humberto, you can see right here, it looks like it is going to slide off the coast of Bermuda, but you are under a tropical storm watch for the little island of Bermuda. It should become, by tomorrow afternoon, a major hurricane, then start to come down and disintegrate as it hits these cooler waters, moving on up and out and not bothering anybody, which is a blessing. Now, this is the Euro model. We always use these models to see what may develop, what we need to look for. After we see that, that's when we start the science end of it, to see if it actually does form, or to see how strong it may get, or if it may form and dissipate, where it may go, all of the stuff I just told you about. This is just a guide as to where it looks like conditions are right for something to possibly form. So first, here we go. It's 7 a.m. I've got this set for 7 a.m. this morning. Here's the system around Texas. Here is Humberto. Here is possibly what could turn into Imelda. And later on, we have a possible Jerry that could be a big storm. I'm not saying it's going to be. It's too far out, but you will see it. First, let's take these one at a time. We know Humberto is not going to threaten anybody in Bermuda and the eastern coast of the United States, also for our friends on the eastern coast of Canada. But here we have this system. We're going to move it up to around 2 p.m. this afternoon. And you can see it's still kind of just hanging around a little, trying to get a little vorticity. That's what the National Hurricane Center was talking about. It might get a chance for a little bit of wind, but it's no big deal, people. Trust me. Trust me on this. We'll put the wind on right quick. You can see this wind is nothing, okay? 17 knots. No big deal, okay? You can handle it with no problem. But here we go with the rain. Let's put the rain and the thunder back on again. So you'll see we'll move up to around 9 p.m. tonight. You can see that Louisiana also around the coastline's getting a little rain. And we got these systems now that's kind of squeezing this thing. Once it gets up here, though, it's going to do a little more. At 5 a.m. Wednesday morning, you can see how this is going to move, and these thunderstorms right around the coastline are going to bring some more heavier rain. And some of this rain, as we move up to around 2 p.m. Wednesday, is going to start tracking further to the north-northeast. Little bit, like I say, it's a little bit of vorticity, but it's not. It's no storm. It's no tropical storm. It's really just a high-end low pressure that's going to bring some well-needed rain to a lot of people at 11 p.m. for tomorrow night. Lots of rain going on. You can see how this rain is traveling. We'll go to Thursday around 2 p.m. And like I say, you can see it's moving on up the coast. I hope all my friends that need some rain certainly does get it, bringing rain to Louisiana. And then we'll go to Friday, the 20th, around 9 a.m. in the morning. You can see how this heavier rain is moving right on up northerly. Now, when we're going to skip up a little bit, we'll go over to Saturday around 5 a.m. right quickly. And you can see that this system, and see how this is moving up like I told you it would. Okay, over here, this doesn't look like a whole lot, just a low pressure system or a depression, okay? But this could turn into a Imelda. Now, I'm going to hop up to Monday. Now, this is a few days out, but you see now that this system is got just a little bit of vorticity to it. So we will turn the wind on right quick. What's the sustained winds? 32 knots. It wants to be a tropical storm. We'll see what happens. Winds out here now. 55 knots. Could be a tropical storm by Monday morning early. And if it does become one, it's going to be a Imelda. Now it should like bypass you guys. This is just a little low, no problem. This is just rain for you guys down here as of now. Okay? You could have some wind. What's the wind looking like down here? 35 knots, you can handle that. It's not a great big bad storm. But this should be unmelded. This is just a low pressure system. But over here, by early Monday morning, we could have the start of Jerry. Now, this is looking like Monday is a long, long ways away. Okay, let's turn the rain and thunder back on. I have looked at several models, and I have done a little science on some, okay? Looking like it may even come a little bit further than this model is showing it now, and then it's going to try to come up. But this high pressure is going to push it. So hopefully, we'll have to keep our eyes on it. It's going to get close, okay? But hopefully, it will go out to sea. That's what I'm thinking on this one. I could change my mind. It's way too early to tell. Way too early to tell. And for you folks down here, this isn't a great big deal right now going across the islands. But this one, as we move on up to Monday evening, the 23rd at 11 p.m., you can see how it looks like maybe a possible chance for a milda to form. It begins to ride this pressure granite right here. Here's this high that keeps pushing it. You can see this when it gets over the island is a little of nothing now. It's just rain, rain, rain. But over here, what's looking like could be a possible Jerry keeps on forming up. Now, Tuesday the 24th at 10 p.m. Remember how I told you a milda may just move and come up? It all depends on the jet stream, the high and the low pressures, and a whole lot of calculus, okay? I'm just showing you this. This is what looks like is a good thing to go by to get right to try to follow these storms and see what happens. You can see this little system here now is just rain, but this one keeps growing. I want to turn the wind on in this. This is sustained winds, okay? And this would be, 41 knot. So, yeah, it's moving on up there. And if it has any wind gust in it at this time, this could be a big storm if it does happen. 62 knot wind gust. So, this is Tuesday. We'll move on up and get on out of here as far as we can go to around 7 p.m. next Thursday. Now, this is a few days out, and you can see it's looking like, we bring the map down, that Imelda goes on off. That's what it's looking like. This one, no big deal for anything, a rainmaker. This one, possible Jerry. It could have winds in it of 80 knots, so that's moving on up. This would be a hurricane. That's what it's looking like. I'm not saying these things are going to happen, but that's what it's looking like. Our first concern is going to be around Monday, and that concern is going to be this system right here, which it would be Imelda, okay? Our second concern, this is not a concern. Our second concern is going to be if this makes up off the coast of Africa and turns into Jerry, because it could be a big hurricane. And over in the Gulf, as of today, you folks get right, because later tonight or this afternoon possibly, the rain will start. You guys need it. Enjoy it. Just watch out. It could be very heavy in times, maybe 2 or 3 inches at a time in places. And there could be some flash flooding with it, so please don't try to drive through it. And please be careful and aware of your surroundings of what's going on. That's what the tropical outlook is looking like for tropical weather today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I love you all. You know it. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thanks for watching.